Welcome back, and in this advanced demo lesson, you're going to get the chance to experience how to do a practical architecture evolution. Now, one of the things that I find very common amongst my students is that they complete the certification, and as soon as they get their first job interview, many of them which have an architectural scenario component, they struggle on how to get started, how to design an architecture for a given scenario. So in this advanced demo series, you're going to step through and evolve an architecture yourself. So you'll start with a single EC2 instance running the WordPress blogging engine, and this single instance will be running the application itself, the database, and it will be storing the content for all of the blog posts. And for this example, we're going to assume it's an animal pictures blog. Now, crucially, in this first stage, you're going to build this server manually to experience all of the different components that need to operate to produce this web application. Once you've built the instance manually, next you'll replicate the process but using a launch template to provide automatic provisioning of this WordPress application. But crucially, it will still be the one single WordPress instance. Next, you'll perform a database migration, moving the MySQL database off the EC2 instance and running it on a dedicated RDS instance. So now the database, the data of this application, will exist outside the lifecycle of the EC2 instance. And this is the first step of moving towards a fully elastic, scalable architecture. Next, once you've migrated the database, instead of storing the content locally on the EC2 instance, you'll provision the Elastic File System, or EFS, which provides a network-based, resilient, shared file system. And you'll migrate all of the content for the WordPress application from the instance to this Elastic File System. Once done, these are all the components required to move this architecture to be fully elastic, and that is being able to scale out or in based on load on that system. So the next step will be to move away from your customers connecting directly to this single EC2 instance. Instead, you'll provision an auto-scaling group which will allow instances to scale out or in as required, and you'll configure an elastic load balancer to point at that auto-scaling group, so your customers will connect in via the application load balancer rather than connecting to the instances directly. And this will abstract your customers away from the instances. It will allow your system to be fully resilient, self-healing, and fully elastically scalable. So by completing this advanced demo lesson, you'll learn how to get started with scenario-based questions as part of job interviews. With that being said, let's go ahead and get started, and to do that, we need to move to the AWS console. To get started, you're going to need to be logged in to a full AWS account without any restrictions. You should be logged in as an admin user. If you're watching this demo as part of any of my courses, then you need to use the general AWS account. So that's the management account of the AWS organization, which we've set up in the course. And as always, please make sure that you've selected the Northern Virginia region. Now, attached to this lesson are two links. One of them is a one-click provision for the base infrastructure of this advanced demo lesson, and the other is a link to the GitHub repository, which contains text-based instructions for every stage of this advanced demo. So to start with, go ahead and click on the one-click provisioning link. This is going to take you to the quick create stack page, and everything should be pre-populated. The stack name should say A4LVPC. All you need to do is check this acknowledgement box and then go ahead and click on create stack. Now you'll need to wait for this stack to move from create in progress to create complete before you can continue with the demo. So go ahead and pause the video and you can resume it once this stack is in a create complete state. So now this stack's moved into the create complete state, the first stage of this advanced demo series is to manually create a single instance WordPress deployment. Now this CloudFormation template has created the architecture that you can see on screen now, so the VPC together with the three-tier architecture, so database, application, and public, split across three different availability zones. So what you're going to do in this first part of this demo series is to create this single EC2 instance, and you're going to do it manually so that you can experience all of the associated limitations. So make sure that you do have the text-based instructions open, and the link for those is attached to this lesson because it will make it easier because you can copy and paste any commands or any configuration items. The first thing to do though is to click on Services, and then type EC2 into the services dropdown and click on EC2 to move to the EC2 console. We're going to be launching our WordPress instance. So what I need you to do is to click on Launch Instance and then again on Launch Instance. Now you should be fairly familiar with creating an EC2 instance, so we're going to go through this part relatively quickly. So first, you need to name the EC2 instance, so go ahead and enter WordPress-manual in the name box. And then scroll down and I'll need you to pick Amazon Linux, specifically Amazon Linux 2 HVM, so make sure that's selected in the drop-down and it should be listed as free tier eligible. Additionally, make sure that it says 64-bit x86. Once set, scroll down again and go to the Instance Type box. Click in the drop-down and just make sure that you have a free tier eligible instance selected. For most people, this should be T2.micro, but just make sure that it's an equivalent sized instance which is under the free tier. Continue scrolling down and under the key pair box, just click in the drop-down and select Proceed without a key pair because we won't be connecting to this instance using an SSH key, we'll be using Session Manager. Once selected, scroll down further still and click on Edit next to Network Settings. In the VPC box, make sure that A4L VPC is selected. This is the Animals for Life VPC created by the one-click deployment. Then under Subnet, make sure that SN-PUB-A is selected. This is the public subnet in Availability Zone A. Below this, make sure that for both auto-assign public IP and auto-assign IPv6 IP, both of these need to be set to enable. Once done, scroll down again, and next to Firewall Security Groups, check the box to say to select an existing security group. And then in the drop-down, make sure that you pick A4L VPC-SG WordPress. Now this will be followed by some randomness and that's okay, just make sure that it's the SG-WordPress security group. This will allow us to connect into this instance using TCP port 80, which is HTTP. Once selected, scroll down, and we won't be making any changes to the storage. We'll be using the default of 8GB of GP2 storage. Below this, expand advanced details, and there are a couple of things that we need to change. First, click on the drop-down under IAM Instance Profile, and just make sure that you select the A4L VPC-WordPress Instance Profile. And again, this will have some randomness after it, and that's okay. Scroll down, and next you're looking for a box which says Credit Specification. Now for this, my preference is that you select Unlimited, because this will make the performance of the EC2 instance potentially better than not selecting anything at all or selecting Standard. Now on brand new AWS accounts, it's relatively common that you can't select Unlimited. AWS don't allow you generally to select Unlimited until the account has a billing history. So you might want to select Standard here to avoid any problems. I'm going to select Unlimited because my account allows it, but if you've got a new AWS account, then go ahead and select Standard. If you do choose to select Unlimited and you do receive an error, then you can go ahead and repeat this process, but select Standard. So go ahead and select Standard in your case, and then scroll down. And that's everything that we need to set at this point. Everything else looks good. So go ahead and click on Launch Instance. Now our instance is provisioning, so just scroll down and go ahead and click on View Instances, and that will allow us to monitor the progress. Now we'll need this to be in a running state before we perform the WordPress installation, but there's one more set of steps that I want to do first. Now throughout this advanced demo lesson, we're going to be taking this single instance WordPress application and moving it towards a fully scalable or an elastically scalable design. Now to do that, we need to move away from statically set setting any configuration options. So we're going to make use of the parameter store, which is part of Systems Manager, and we're going to create some parameters that our automatic build processes later in this demo will utilize. For now, we're going to be performing everything manually, but we'll still be using these variables because it will simplify what we have to type in the EC2 instance. So go ahead and click on Services, start typing Systems Manager, and then once you see it populated in the list, you can right-click and open that in a new tab. Once you're at the Systems Manager console, on the left, under Application Management, just locate Parameter Store and click it to move to the Parameter Store console, and we're going to create a number of parameters. Now, if you're watching this demo as part of my courses, you may already have some parameters listed on this screen. If you have any existing ones which begin with /A4L, then go ahead and delete them before continuing. So go ahead and click on Create Parameter, and the exact naming for each of these is in the full instructions contained on the GitHub repository, which is attached to this lesson. So make sure you've got that open. It'll make it significantly easier and less prone to errors. We're going to create a number of parameters for WordPress, and the first is the database username, so the username that will have permissions on the WordPress database. So I want you to set the name to /A4L/WordPress/DBUser. For description, WordPress database user. You can set the tier for the parameter to standard or advanced. To keep things in the free tier, we're going to use standard. It's going to be a string parameter. The data type is going to be text, and the value needs to be our actual database username. So for this demonstration, we're going to use A4L WordPress user. So enter that and click on Create Parameter. Now we're going to be moving quicker now that you've seen the process. Our next parameter is going to be the database name. So enter this in the name field. For description, WordPress database name. Again, standard string data type of text. And the value is going to be the WordPress database name. So A4L WordPress DB, scroll down and click on Create Parameter. Next is going to be the database endpoint, so the host name that WordPress will connect to. So for name, enter this, A4L WordPress DB endpoint. For the description, WordPress endpoint name, again, standard, string, text for data type. And then to start with, because the database is on the same instance as the application, the value will be localhost. So enter that and go ahead and click on Create Parameter. Next, we'll be creating a parameter to store the password of the WordPress user. So click on Create Parameter. This time it's A4L WordPress DB password. For description, WordPress DB password. Again, standard tier, but this time it's going to be a secure string. For KMS key source, use current account. And then for KMS key ID, it will be alias AWS SSM, which is the default customer master key that's created by KMS. For value, go ahead and enter a strong password. Again, this is for the WordPress user that has permissions to access the database. So if this were production, it would need to be a strong password. Now, I recommend that you use the same password as I'm using in this demo. It uses number letter substitution, and I know that it works with all of the different system components. Now, I've included this password in the text-based instructions, and I do recommend that you use it in your demo as well. Go ahead and enter something in this value and then scroll down and click on Create Parameter. And then last time, click on Create Parameter again. For name, this time A4L WordPress DB root password, and this is the root password for the local database server that's running on the EC2 instance. So for description, WordPress DB root password, standard again, and then again secure string because we're storing a password. KMS key source is my current account, leave everything else as default, and then enter another strong password. If this were production, generally this would be different from the previous password, but as this is a demo, you should use the same strong password as you used previously. Whichever you choose, go ahead and enter that into the value box, and then click on Create Parameter. Okay, so this is the end of part one of this lesson. It was getting a little bit on the long side, and I wanted to give you the opportunity to take a small break, maybe stretch your legs or make a coffee. Now, part two will continue immediately from this point, so go ahead, complete this video, and when you're ready, I'll look forward to you joining me in part two.